Hi, my name is Dr. Rajiv Kumar Chauhan. I am going to discuss about SoC or state of charge of the battery, depth of discharge or DoD of the battery, efficiency of the battery in this lecture. So, state of charge or SoC of the battery. The state of charge is the level of charge of an electric battery relative to its capacity. The unit of SoC are percentage points, 0 for empty and 100% for full. Okay, so the SoC is the ratio of charge stored mu t in the battery to the nominal capacity of the battery mu n. The SoC can be defined as SoC is equals to the mu t divided by mu n into 100. So in this example, we can say it in this tutorial sheet, 12 volt battery with capacity of 500 ampere hour is at 80% SoC. Find the charge stored and energy delivered to the load. So in this questions, the SoC of the battery is given to us. The battery voltage is given. Battery capacity is also given to us. So charge is stored at 80% SoC. So 80% SoC mean actually the we want to find out the value of mu t. Okay, so mu t, as we know, the SoC is the ratio of mu t by mu n. Okay, so we can calculate the mu t from here. So we know the mu n. Okay, we know the SoC. So we want to find out the stored. So mu n is equals to 500 as given in the question. And the SoC level is 80%. So we have mentioned it 80 divided by 100 to represent it in the percent. Okay, because this is given in the percent, we want to get it numeric. So 500 into 0.8 is equals to, we know the charge is stored at 80% SoC when the battery level is, the SoC level is 80% is the 400 ampere hour. Okay, so power being delivered to the load is equals to, or this is energy. Okay, is equals to the charge stored in the battery multiplied the battery voltage, and that is 4800 watt hour. This is basically theoretically. We are considering that battery is going to discharge up to 0% or 0% SoC. Okay, practically, actually, it is not possible, but theoretically, we can consider it. Now, the depth of discharge, your depth of the discharge, DoD of the battery. So, depth of discharge of a battery determines the function of power that can be withdrawn from the battery. For example, in this circuit, we can see I have considered a 12 volt 200 ampere hour battery. The output voltage will be 12 volt, okay, and the capacity will be 200 ampere hour. So for example, depth of discharge of a battery is given by the manufacturer as 25%. Okay, then only 25% battery capacity can be used to supply the load, or can be used by the load. So what does it mean, 25%? It means the battery is charged up to 100%, but only the first 25% rating we can use to supply the load. We can discharge this battery up to only 75% of the SOC. So first of all, what we will do, we will calculate the capacity. Okay, so the battery capacity is given, nominal capacity is given 500 ampere hour, while the depth of discharge is 25%, can only be provided the 500 multiplied by 0.25 is equals to 125 ampere hour. This is just like a, we have the one bottle, one cell, this, and I am saying this is 25%, this is 50, this is 75, and this is 100. Okay. But as per the question, we can use only this part. Okay. Remaining we cannot use. As per the manufacturer has mentioned that only first 25% you can use. So that's why only the battery capacity is 500 ampere hour, while in this condition or with this depth of discharge, we can use only 125 ampere hour. So this is the meaning of depth of discharge of a battery. So in this question, a 12 volt battery capacity of 500 ampere hour with a depth of discharge 25% is mentioned in this question. Find the charge to be delivered and energy delivered to the load. Okay, so first of all, the battery capacity is given. We will note it down, the given point. 12 volt battery voltage is given, depth of discharge is given, that is 25%. So charge to be delivered to the load is equals to the capacity multiplied by the depth of discharge. And if we want to convert it from the percentage point to the regular decimal points, we will divide it by 100, depth of discharge, because this is in percentage. Okay, so the charge to be delivered to the load, Q is equals to 500 ampere hour multiplied by 25 divided by 100 is equals to 500 ampere hour multiplied by 0.25 and 125 ampere hour. The energy to be delivered to the load is equals to the charge multiplied by voltage. Okay, and Q we have already calculated 125. So if we will multiply 125 ampere hour by the voltage, we will get the watt hour, and that is 1500 watt hour. So we get the answer for this part of this question. Okay, now this is the another question. A 12 volt battery capacity of 500 ampere hour, that is theoretically at 80% SOC. So in this question, the state of charge of the battery is given 80%, and the depth of discharge is 50%. In the previous question, the depth of discharge was 25% only, and that time the SOC was not mentioned. Okay, so find the charge stored and energy delivered to the load. Okay, so here first of all, we will note it down, the given point, the SOC of the battery is given 80%, voltage is given 12 volt, nominal capacity of the battery is given 500 ampere hour, and depth of discharge is given. So what is the meaning of this? The theoretically, the charge stored at 80% SOC is equals to, so charge stored at 80% SOC to be delivered to the load. So to be delivered to the load, it means the battery, the 500 ampere hour battery is at the 80%, means already 20% energy charge has been discharged. Okay, so we have the 80% only, and we can discharge this battery up to 50% only. So what is the total remaining charge which we can use to supply the load is 80% minus 50. Okay, to convert it into the decimal, we have just divided by 100, so, and multiplied by nominal capacity. So nominal capacity of the battery is 500 ampere hour multiplied by 80 minus 50 is equal to 30 divided by 100. So 500 multiplied by 0.3 is equals to 150 ampere hour. So we have the 150 ampere hour that can be used to supply the load. Okay, so because of this charge, we will see that energy being delivered to the load is equals to, first of all, multiplied by the charge stored or charge remained to supply the load, multiplied by the battery capacity or battery voltage. Okay, that is 12 volt. So 150 multiplied by 12 is equals to 1800 watt hour. Now next topic is the battery efficiency. Battery efficiency, this is also important parameter. So the battery efficiency is the ratio of the energy retrieved from the battery to the energy provided to the battery. So battery efficiency is equals to, we can say, output divided by input. So input is represented by WIN and output is represented by W output. So output is nothing, output is just input minus losses, where the WLC is losses in charge from electrical to the chemical. Okay, losses in electrical to the chemical conversion, and losses of discharge means, in the case of discharge, the battery chemical energy is converted to the electrical. So loss in chemical to electrical conversion. So here battery efficiency is W output divided by W in, and W output is W in minus losses, energy loss in charging, or WLC minus energy loss in discharging of the battery divided by the energy input to the battery. So efficiency is equals to, from here we can find out the W in is divided by W in, so 1 minus WLC plus WLD divided by W in.